125 million Americans, that's 38% of the population, are now fully vaccinated. 138 million, 48%, has had at least one shot. Children ages 12 to 15 are also getting vaccinated. So now the country is beginning to turn its focus on helping vaccinate the world.
We will not use our vaccines to secure favors from other countries.
Earlier this week, President Joe Biden announced an additional 20 million doses of the AstraZeneca vaccine, a total of 80 million doses to be shared via COVAX, the UN mechanism for lower and middle-income countries to access vaccines. It's part of an early phase of a global strategy his administration has yet to outline. But they insist U.S. efforts will be different than the vaccine diplomacy of China and Russia. Both have provided tens of millions of doses in many countries, but some say they come with strings attached.
What we see China and Russia trying to do is, in effect, use small amounts of vaccine sales to extract political concessions and gain political influence. What we want to do is use a mass response to end the pandemic and let that be the legacy of what America is trying to do here.
Biden is expected to shore up a global pandemic response strategy at the G7 summit in June. This group of the world's most advanced economies say they want to lead in pandemic recovery, but they are also the ones criticized as vaccine hoarders.
Wealthy countries could vaccinate 100% of their population, including children, and still have 1.3 billion doses left over to share. And if we look at more realistic numbers, like say 70% of their population, there would be almost 2 billion doses to share. So what we're asking these wealthy countries to do is look at their pipeline of vaccines and start making plans to share doses immediately so that we can be scaling up vaccine access around the world.
The U.S., with decades of success dealing with previous global health crises, has an advantage compared to China and Russia.
Whether it's the Ebola pandemic in West Africa or its contribution to the Global Fund to fight AIDS, tuberculosis, and malaria, I'm very confident that the U.S. is going to step up and play an important leadership role in the global COVID-19 response going forward.
Gil Smith, Biden's point person for global pandemic response, said the U.S. effort could be as ambitious as the Marshall Plan.
In the summer of 1947, Secretary of State Marshall had proposed to aid the nations of Europe.
An American program providing aid to Western Europe after World War II.
The Marshall Plan was indeed about resources. It was also about policies. It was also about markets and dealing with the economic impacts of World War II. And similarly, we've got the same kinds of impacts in this pandemic. I think it is worth thinking that boldly.
Just how bold, the world is waiting to see. Beyond donating doses, the U.S. has pledged $4 billion for COVAX and has supported waiving vaccine patents at the World Trade Organization. At Siwida Kuswara, VOA News.